I walked out of the bank just as I realized it was being held up. I didn't know what to do, run or hide in the bushes. So, without thinking, I turned around and walked back in the bank. The thief saw me and said,
"Get down on the ground!"
I followed his instructions and got down on the floor. Then he pointed to me and said,
"You! Get up! You're coming with me."
I got up and followed him. He got in his car and sped away. We sped past other cars at first, just stoplights, until we finally came to a parking lot. We got out of the car and quickly got into another. Then we took off at a normal speed and drove that way from then on, stopping at stoplights and obeying all the rules. We drove out past the city limits and into the countryside. If I didn't know any better, I'd say it was a pretty ride. Beautiful trees and quaint little cottages. We drove for about an hour, then pulled off on a little lane and followed that for another 20 minutes. Then we stopped by a small cottage and got out. We walked in and turned on the lights. He said, "Sit down." I did. And he got out a rope and tied me up. Ever wanted to go back. There was a little grocery store about 5 miles away, and that was all we needed. We hunted deer, and one was all we needed to make it through the winter. Then one day, Thomas got sick. Call a doctor. later he died. To my surprise, he left me everything. The money from the bank robbery and the cabin. I stayed on there for the rest of my life. Never marrying, never having children. I had everything I wanted, everything I needed.
Everything but Thomas.